guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm in. If you're new here, you know, appreciate you for tuning in, for watching, clicking on the vid. Today we're gonna be reacting to Nicki and J. Cole's new song, bro. I love Nicki and I love J. Cole. J. Cole's number one for me. Like all time. Just every genre, just J. Cole number one. Raw Wave coming in number two. Then between between Pac and Wayne, probably got number three. Youngboy, four. I don't know, bro. Yeah. Just Pac and Wayne because they started that shit. You feel me? That's when it all started for me. It all started. You know, I love Lil Wayne. But anyways, J. Cole. I can't wait to hear J. Cole's verse. Nicki, I already know she gonna eat. Because that's what Nicki does, nigga. She don't just drop for no reason. Like she ain't dropping no doo doo either. Like I don't think Nicki's ever dropped a bad song. I also don't be keeping up with Nicki like that though. I listen to a lot of her old shit. What the freak, man? Just keep the liquid in your mouth. And this is not pee, by the way. I might need, like, some of y'all niggas might need to be told that. It's just some mango lime shit. You feel me? But, let's get right into it. I know the, I think it was Red something. Red. I don't freaking know. But that was the last song of her I think I listened to. So, yeah. It's been a minute. But I'm ready to get into it. And I'm so excited for J. Cole's verse, bro. We about to play this bit like 3, 4, 5 times in this video, bro. Let's get it. It's 4:20. 4 minutes and 20 seconds.
Pull up and I almost hit him. He acting like I ain't always with him. My heart saying I love him while I'm screaming out I hate him. And ain't no more debating, this time it's the ultimatum. I never forgot where I was at the first day I met him. Yeah, it was love at first sight, but I ain't never sweat him. I knew if it was meant to be that one day I would let him. 20 years later, them decisions, I don't regret them. Just wish you would give me.
Okay, is she talking about her hubby? Y'all was so happy when I heard that Nicki had a hubby and a baby, bro. Like, y'all don't even know, bro. Like, cause them's the people you grow up with, and you're like, dang, they gonna grow old and like have families and retire eventually, bro. And like, you gonna be grown up, and it's like, so I'm hitting 19 this year, so it's just, it's a lot, nigga. It's a lot. But nah, I was so proud of Nicki, so happy for her, bro. Like, it's so hard to find a good person to grow your life with and have your kids with nowadays, bro. Especially when you that high up in the fucking game, bro. Like, you can't trust nobody. Like, everybody's out for a different type of shit. It ain't nothing real. Like, you all alone. So it's like, I'm happy for her, for real. Because everybody doesn't get the opportunity.
Space when I really need it to be alone in my zone. When I'm pull up and I almost hit him. He acting like I ain't always with him. My heart saying I love him while I'm screaming out I hate him. And ain't no more debating, this time it's the ultimatum. I never forgot where I was at the first day I met him. Yeah, it was love at first sight, but I ain't never sweat him. I knew if it was meant to be that one day I would let him. 20 years later, them decisions, I don't regret them. Just wish you would give me space when I really need it. To be alone in my zone when I'm really heated. Just cause I am quiet, don't mean you're defeated. Wish you ain't need it.
Nah, she's spitting about this. Like, I wasn't expecting Nicki to come on like this.
Pull up and I almost hit him. He acting like I ain't know he's with him. My heart saying I love him while I'm screaming out I hate him. And ain't no more debating, this time it's the ultimatum. I never forgot where I was at the first day I met him. Yeah, it was love at first sight, but I ain't never sweat him. I knew if it was meant to be that one day I would let him. 20 years later, them decisions, I don't regret them. Just wish you would give me space when I really need it. To be alone in my zone when I'm really heated. Just cause I am quiet, don't mean you're defeated. Wish you ain't need me to.
So wish you would just give me space when I really need it. Just because I'm quiet don't mean you defeated. She's spitting.
Space when I really need it. To be alone in my zone when I'm really heated. Just because I am quiet don't mean you're defeated. Wish you ain't need me to feel like you're completed. Don't want to say something mean and I don't mean it. Million missed calls, I don't want to.
That's, bruh. My mom always told me, bruh, if you ain't got nothing nice to say, don't say it at all, bruh. And I've been quiet ever since. Like, bruh. It's like, I'm not even joking. I'm not even joking. Ask, nigga. Ask around, nigga. I don't talk. I talk to you guys, because, like, this is the shit I love to do. This is the shit I want to do. But nah, people weird, man. People weird, and I'm just the honest, blunt, straight up, like, tell it how it is person. People don't like that. So I'm gonna just stay quiet most of the time. Unless they ask me a question or some shit, like, I'm quiet. Like, I ain't got time for all that. Nikki get it. Nikki understands.
I knew if it was meant to be that one day I would let them. 20 years later, them decisions, I don't regret them. Just wish you would give me space when I really need it. To be alone in my zone when I'm really heated. Just cause I am quiet don't mean you're defeated. Wish you ain't need me to feel like you're completed. Don't wanna say something mean when I don't mean it. Million missed calls, I don't wanna talk. Just did a detox, now I wanna spark.
Jeez, bruh, she's snapping. Even on the little one-liners, bruh.
Something mean when I don't mean it. Million missed calls, I don't wanna talk.
Ooh, a million missed calls, nigga. Nigga, I get one missed call and I don't wanna talk. Like, there's a reason it's a missed call. I didn't pick up. No, let me stop. That's mean. To the people that do call me, I appreciate the calls. Even though most of the time it's spam. Or people asking for shit or the wrong number. So
just did a detox, now I wanna spark.
Yeah. Hey, the song is 420 and she just said Nikki trying to spark, bro. So we gonna, I ain't hit the pen all morning, bro. It's early as fuck right now for me, bro. I ain't even gonna lie. Like, I have been burnt out for the past couple days, bro, and I cannot catch up. No matter how much good sleep I get, how much sleep I get, I just wake up still feeling tired and exhausted. And it's like, I can't go back to sleep once I'm waking up. I'm just ready to go at it again. But, like, shit, we working on that. It's just something I gotta get used to and shit. Like, it's been, like, probably, like, 2-3 months I've been just, like, working harder than, like, probably I ever have. And this nigga, we ain't stopping either. We ain't done. Nowhere near done. So, I'm gonna have to, I don't know. I think my body and my mind just, it's gonna have to adjust sooner or later to this shit. But yeah, nah, I've been tired. I got a headache. It's crazy.
And it was beautiful. I made a sign for you. They say you're beautiful. You're so.
Ooh, gotta run it back. I heard the goat, nigga. I done heard the goat speak. Did y'all know many goats could speak? Did y'all know the goats could speak English?
Having hurry for the faint of heart. She bad as fuck, but hard to deal with, and it ain't a fault. She got ambition like the niggas in a vision for herself, so she can't rest until.
I was finna say that when she was like, I don't want to speak and all the other shit. Like, Nicki a fucking alpha, bruh. And y'all can't deny that shit at all. That's why it's gonna take a different type of nigga to deal with her. That's why she's been so D-low and not fucking with everybody, not fucking everybody. And just staying quiet and shit. Like, that's alpha shit, nigga. What? And it's just alpha, like, I don't know. Alpha females, they different, bro. They different. Like, an alpha male, you see them and you can, I don't know. It's just different. They built differently. I think it's because they've been through, like, a bunch of shit. And, yeah. It makes them stronger, but it also just leaves, like, scars and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Like, when you trip, scrape your knee, it's like, well, I made it through, but I got this scar. It'll heal, but it'll still be there. Anyways, I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. Well, I know what I'm talking about. J. Cole was like, she got the ambition just like a nigga. And it's like, females is really out here doing that shit, on that shit, on boss things. Boss things, bro. Barbie boss things, you feel me? We up, nigga. Y'all niggas better... Nah, niggas... niggas is already... They mad. They sad. They pissed off. You can tell the ones that are hurt by it, bro. Y'all the problem. But we not gonna speak on that.
Deal with it and ain't a fault. She got ambition like the niggas in a vision.
Let me run it back.
Having hurry for the faint of heart. She bad as fuck, but hard to deal with, and it ain't a fault. She got ambition like the niggas in a vision for herself, so she can't rest until she feel like she done made a mark. So
when God, never- that's what I'm saying. Like, we, most females nowadays, we're not focused. Well, I'm not, I won't even say most, but some. Like, we're not focused on love and all that goo goo gaga shit, nigga. Because we done been hurt by that shit. We know how. We know how it's going to play out already, nigga. We want to be more than that, nigga. Like, this is not the 1960s anymore. Like, nigga, a lot of us didn't even grow up in a family. So it's like, that's not our priority in life when we come from literally nothing. Or when we come from a situation that we want to get out of, it's like, our first priority isn't to go find a good man and have kids. Nigga, we trying to get out. We trying to save the community. We trying to save people around us, nigga, because we didn't have that shit. There is no security, no little blankie to wrap up in when you come from where we from, nigga. You either boss up or you be a bitch. You want to be a boss or a bitch, nigga? Or you want to be a boss bitch? Exactly. Exactly.
Then you gotta learn to play a part. Sometimes you gotta play the bat, but when you do, make sure you play it small. All these niggas want us, so they hate it hard.
You give me once, better give me right, because you won't never give me twice. Ain't got time to be out here playing games. Little boy, little girl shit, nigga. We not in middle school. We not in elementary, like. Nigga, I'm grown, you grown, like, be grown. Or be gone. Be grown or be gone, nigga.
They talking slick and make you want to pull a rate at all. You like a lover, like a brother, like a manager, an A&R. Plus a therapist when it start raining hard. Her life was trauma filled, it left her with a tainted heart. Yeah, you the nigga that she want to tat her name across. But you need patience and a lot of extra faith in God to keep the family.
That's what, like, I swear. He's speaking. Speaking to me, bruh. I hear you, J. Cole. I hear you, Nicki. Nah, that shit hurt. That shit hit different. I feel targeted.
She got ambition like the niggas in a vision for herself, so she can't rest until she feel like she done made a mark. So if you love her, then you gotta learn to play a part. Sometimes you gotta play the bet, but when you do, make sure you play it smart. All these niggas want her, so they hating hard. They talking slick and make you wanna pull a rate at all. You like a lover, like a brother, like a manager, an A&R, plus a therapist when it start raining hard. Her life was trauma filled, it left her with a...
It's hard to love and it's hard to be loved at certain points in your life. Especially when you've been through shit. And you're trying to change and grow and heal. That shit is not pretty, bro. Like, I'm telling you right now. People make it all, oh, positivity, healing, growth. But nah, nigga. That shit ugly. That shit hurt. That shit tiresome. Like, but at the end of the day, it's worth it. Because, like, we ain't got no other choice. You either sit in that depression, sit in that trauma, sit in that pain, or you go and make something better out of it. But it's going to take a lot out of you, bro. Like, it's going to take a lot. And that's why, like, the people in your life that know you going through shit and know that, they're going to have to be patient. That's the number one thing you're going to have. If you love it, if you have someone in your life that you know has gone through shit and they're on a path to heal and grow, like, you got to understand, pain makes change. So for them to change and go through the cycles and do all these things to become better, like, it's going to hurt. It's going to hurt people around them. It's going to hurt them. Like, it's not going to be easy. It's going to take a long time. That's why patience, bro. Y'all gotta have patience. Y'all gotta have faith. For real. For real, for real. But I ain't saying, like, let people drag you through the mud and, like, shit on you and, like, hell nah, walk all over you. Don't do that shit. But, like, if y'all really locked in, and I'm talking about anybody, not even just your significant other, but, like, everybody, like, anybody in your life, if y'all locked in for real and y'all know that, like, y'all are gonna go through the changes together. Y'all gonna go through the pain together. Y'all gonna go through the growth together, bro. And that's just some real nigga shit.
So she can't rest until she feel like she done made a mark. So if you love her, then you gotta learn to play a part. Sometimes you gotta play the bet, but when you do, make sure you play it smart. All these niggas want her, so they hating hard. They talking slick and make you wanna pull a rate at all. You like a lover, like a brother, like a manager, an A&R, plus a therapist when it start raining hard. Her life was trauma filled, it left her with a tainted heart. Yeah, you the nigga that she wanna tat her name across. But you need patience and a lot of extra faith.
That's just special, man. Special, man. Everybody wants to be wanted. Everybody wants to be loved and shit. No matter what you go through, no matter who you are, how, what, like, none of that shit matters, bro. So it's like, especially with a person who don't trust, they're not out here looking for all that shit. Once you, like, you know, once you've made it past that threshold and, like, you've become their person, like, it's just a different type of feeling. Because it's like, damn, I know you don't let anybody else in. And it just hit different. It's real, nigga. It's real. You can feel it's real.
God, to keep the family together at a time when it's so regular to break apart. So God forbid y'all got a kid, therefore I hate the thought.
Ooh, that was... Nah, y'all gotta listen to this song, y'all. This song, the go. I should have known, though. J. Cole, with J. Cole in it, like... And Nicki, you know, Nicki, like, bruh. Like I said, Nicki ain't never made a bad song. And I really fuck with Nicki. Yeah. Like, I can't talk about what she does in her personal life or her personal life. Like, I don't, I mean, other than, like, the baby and husband thing. I was really proud of her for that. But other than that, like, I don't pay attention to that shit. I'm not into that. Like, I don't care. Like, the girl is a legend. Living legend. And, like, she's one of them artists that people didn't, she didn't have to ask to get her flowers. She got them, like, off the rip, nigga. And it's like, she was coming up when females weren't really even in the game. So it was like, she was the only one that stood out. And, like, she's better than the niggas out here. Back then, she was better than the rappers are now. Back then, she was better than niggas, rappers older than she was. Like, and that's just like, I don't know. You can't hate on someone who you've seen come so far and do so much good. Like, how are you gonna hate on that? Like, at that point, you're just envious. You jealous. But, like, nah. Nicki one of them ones, for real. And J. Cole, like, y'all already know. If he number one for me, like, that, I feel like that, for me, that means a lot. Because, like, I'm a pick and choose. I'm a picky person with everything. Like, picky music, like, but I like all music. It just got to be real, and it got to be real, and it got to sound good. And a lot of music out here don't do none of that. So, I'm picky with it. J. Cole number one. And I respect and love Nicki so much. It's not even funny, bro. Like, as a female, I listened to her. She's part of my generation of music. So it's, and there wasn't a lot of females around back then. There really wasn't. There was, like, not in the rap game. I can't think of any. And I love rap my whole childhood, like, throughout childhood. And I know Nicki, other than, like, you go back 90s, 80s, of course, but, like, Iggy, nigga. There was Iggy rap for, like, yeah. But, not Nicki. And she's still relevant. That's what's crazy. But anyways, let me stop fangirling over here. I do love these two, though. It's great.
Yeah, you the nigga that she wanna tat her name across. But you need patience and a lot of extra faith in God.
That's what, like, I swear, bro. Whoever said they love me next, or who falls in love with me next, bro, you better have your name tatted. Or I'm not gonna believe you. Okay, I'm gonna need proof. Show me proof, don't say it. I'm gonna need actions, not words. Or verbal words. It can be like a written word. Like, I love that shit. That's fire. But yeah, nah, I'm done with all this. I'm so serious. Y'all think I'm playing, but I am so serious. Like, I'm... Words mean nothing, bro. They really don't. So you better show me something, nigga. Put some money in that shit or something. Like, I don't even know. Like, you better propose, nigga. I don't care about all that talking. Nah. Get straight to it.
Keep the family together at a time when it's so regular to break apart. So God forbid y'all got a kid, therefore I hate the thought. Hit you and her against the world until it ain't no more. Breath in your lungs, I'm just a messenger. But God is who this message is from. I want to send you my
He said, God is where this message is from. Damn.
When it's so regular to break apart. So God forbid y'all got...
Keeping in a family together when it's so regular. That man spitting. I know that was kind of late. I caught that bar late, but I got to yapping. You know how I be. But he's spitting though, bro. Like, and that's not even with just family. It's just people in general. Like, nobody's like real. Nobody knows what loyalty is nowadays. It's so weird, man. It really is. And it's like, I'm so motherfucking young right now. Up here talking like, but like, I'm just a different. And I have been since I was younger, nigga. Like, I don't vibe with this generation. For real. I really don't. Like, I vibe with older people. Like my granny and my aunts and uncles and my way older cousins. Like, I love my siblings and my, like, you feel me? But once you know what role you play as you grow up, you feel me? Like, as a child, you don't be thinking about that. Like, I gotta, but, like, I was such a thinker. And it's just, I wanted to take care of everybody. I didn't care who it was. That's just was my instinct. And I had the way I thought and processed shit. I could just help everybody around me. And once you, it doesn't matter how old or, you know, how smart people think you are. You know, you're just different. And, cause shit just don't feel the same. It just don't feel the same. But I don't know how I got to this subject, but we gonna play through family. Family, nigga. La familia. La familia. From the womb to the tomb. Y'all watch BMF season 3 out. Y'all go watch it. Episode 1 and 2. I don't know where you're going to watch it. I think it's on Stars. I ain't going to tell y'all where I watch it because y'all ain't got to worry about that. But it's a good fucking show. It's about BMF, obviously. It's called BMF. But if y'all don't know who BMF are, I would tell y'all channel why I ain't going to do you like that because y'all might be a youngin'. Or you might be really old. BMF, Mafia Family, Black Mafia Family, Atlanta, D to Atlanta, to Cali, you feel me? Early 2000s, y'all go check it out. It was made in like 2020 something, the show, but it takes place, you know, in like the early 2000s, early 90s, so, yeah, it's a good show. La Familia, nigga. That's what it's about. I think traditions and customs and society, it all goes through phases. Bad and good. But honestly, I don't think the tradition family should come back. I think the new age, like, version of, like, family and, you know, loyalty, it's gonna become the people we choose it to be. There's not gonna be any more, like, we got the same blood, so it's always, you know, womb to the tomb, loyalty over everything else. But, like, not saying that's how it should be, but I feel like back in the day, it was, people didn't really have the choice. And it was just weird. Some shit's just weird. Especially now that people are weird, it don't matter who, like, it don't matter who you is. If you family, you, like, it just doesn't mean the same today to say, you're my blood, you're my kin, so, like, we locked in. But, like, shit, I be damned. Look, I know what I stand for, but the way I see society going, it's just not, family not gonna mean the same as it used to. Right now, it really doesn't. Like, you hear someone say they family, it's like, okay, friend, associate, like, but no, that's what I say. I don't have friends. Like, I don't have any friends. I got family, and I got, like, people I, like, associate with, you know, just for a little while, for, like, work and shit. But if you're not a family or associate, you just, is what it is. It is what it is.
Got a kid, therefore I hate the thought. Hit you and her against the world until it ain't no more breath in your lungs.
You against the world. So people get it twisted and think it's them versus. World's fucked up.
It's a message. If God is who this message is from, I want to send you my respect because I rep for the ones that hold their wifey down despite all of the extras that come.
I swear, nah, for real. Like, bruh. Y'all don't even know. Okay? Because niggas make it look so hard and make it look so just, I don't know, to be a husband. And it's like, you just, that's why, so when I see, like, a good husband, because I know Nikki ain't going to pick no bimbo. Like, she waited a long time for that shit. She just, like, and the way she handles her family and all her family business, like, that shit, she holds that shit down for real. Like, that's why I can tell she about it. She own it. Like, I trust Nikki's decision-making process. Like, you feel me? Like, she's not dumb. She's not stupid. She knows how the game go. All the games. You know, she's played them before. So it's like, I know she made a good decision in her husband. And he seemed like a real stand-up dude. You feel me? But that, I love to see it, bro. Like, y'all have no idea. Like, good moms, like, good kids, like, good husbands, good wives, like, that shit's beautiful to see. Still to this day, for me, and it's like, I want that, but, like, I don't know if I'll ever get it, or, like, which, that's fine. Like, I don't have a problem missing out on shit if I know it's, like, for the best, or it ain't supposed to happen for me. Like, I don't get tore up about that shit, because I know there'll be, like, those opportunities, doors being closed, that opportunity being taken, it's like, it'll just give me more opportunities, better opportunities that are more suited for me anyway. So it's like, But nah, that shit's cute as fuck. And shout out to all the good moms, all the good wives and husbands out there. Like, y'all hold it down. Y'all real ones. Y'all cherish and love. Y'all don't let that shit go. Y'all work for it. Y'all remember communication's key, but also understanding is very important. Don't let other people get in your ears about shit. Honesty, bruh. Y'all gotta be honest with each other about everything. Not 80% of shit, not 90% of shit. 100, nigga. Stay 100. If with nobody else, with your significant other, bruh. If nobody else. What else I got for y'all? Yeah, that's your best friend. You're gonna be together for life, so y'all make it work. You hear? Y'all don't do any no shit to that would break y'all apart, push y'all each other away. Like, don't do that shit. Cause y'all are for life. You feel me? Go do all that other weird shit with everybody else. No, don't do that. But like, especially not the one that's like with you like forever for life, no matter what. Like, don't do that shit. That's just weird. It's disgusting. But y'all hold it down for real. And congratulations. For real. Proud of y'all.
Word to Willie Smith, these silly niggas heckling Sean as if their life is empty. Flood of extras that come. Word to Willie Smith, these silly niggas heckling Sean as if their life is somehow perfect and they never been plunged into a dark place. So I can't respect when it's done. It's family first through the worst, coming second to none. For real.
What I just said, nigga. Yeah, no, I'm so glad that this song was made, bro. It really shouts out all the, like, people love glorifying the single life or the whole life and the not having kids and like shit, but like, we got two of the realest in the game right now, like, putting on and promoting that family man type shit, that home shit, like, your house ain't a home without people you love. Your house ain't a home without the people you love, bruh. And that's just real nigga shit. I know J. Cole, he get that. You feel me? He was writing songs way back in the day for me, talking about some, you feel me? All that. That Jada and that Will love. Let me stop. That was disrespectful. I should get that. Shout out Willie, my nigga. My nigga Will Smith. One of the greatest actors, y'all can't even deny it. One of the greatest actors of this generation, for sure. For sure. So I hope y'all. Hold on. We still got a minute.
They say you're beautiful.
I really like that song, y'all. I think that's what we needed. One of the songs what we needed, you feel me? It just says the right things, you know? I feel like music always does that for me, bro. It says the right things at the right times, and it's like, wow. Get out of my mind. But yeah, I hope y'all like the video, like the reaction. Y'all go check it out. Check out the song over there. Support my girl Nikki and my nigga J. Cole. They some real ones, for real. Take it from me. Y'all subscribe, like the video, and appreciate y'all for watching.